أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Allahumma ameen ya arhamar rahimin. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these days to forgive all of us. And ya rabbal alameen. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya arhamar rahimin. أن يبلغنا ليلة القدر في هذه الأيام وأن يتقبل منا الصيام والقيامة والنفقة وقراءة القرآن. اللهم أمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. أسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعتق رقابنا ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا من النار برحمته، فهو على ذلك قدير وبالإجابة جدير سبحانه وتعالى. اللهم أمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى in too many آيات in the Holy Quran, we've been reciting and listening to the Quran in the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us like orders, commanding us to follow his orders, not to disobey him, to obey him and to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we talk about the best of our a'mal nowadays, especially in the last 10 days and nights of the month of Ramadan, which is the fruits of the month these days, we have really to struggle, we have to come more to the masjid. We have to make i'tikaf, the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to make too many different types of ibadat, like dhikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reciting Quran, sadaqah, fasting, already we are doing that, giving your zakah, giving your sadaqah, and all of these a'mal, we have to think about it more. There is a hadith, too many details in this hadith, but just I will make it short for you. Hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, Sahabi, his name Abu Malik al-Ash'ari, and Abi Malik al-Ash'ari, Ibn Asim al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, he narrated that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, At-tuhuru shatru al-Iman. At-tuhuru means cleanliness or al-wudu, the ablution before you make salah. Shatr means half. Al-Iman here means the salah. Shatr al-Iman, يعني half of the salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. إِيمَانَكُمْ means يُضِعْ صَلَاتَكُمْ. When the change of al-qibla from Bayt al-Maqdis to al-Ka'bah, what about the salah we prayed before your Rabb? Are you gonna waste it? Nothing for nothing. Allah said no. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will consider it. It will be in the record for you. Don't worry about it. And the iman here means the salah. He said there is no salah without wudu. La salata bidun tuhur. You have to make wudu first before the salah. Tayyib, before you pray your salawat. Fa al-tuhur, the cleanliness inside and outside, cleanliness from spiritually, from any kind of amrad al-khulub, the da'wat and the ma'asi, with zinub, being sinner and all of these. Subhanallah, and physically from any kind of filth, any kind of filth. So that's why tahur, cleanliness, it's half of the salah, like what they said, al-mufassirin and the people of the hadith. So very important to clean yourself, very important. Muslim nazif, Muslim must be clean. And it's half of the salah, like what they said. وَالطهور شطر الإيمان والحمد لله تملأ الميزان. When you say الحمد لله, it will fill the mizan with hasanat. طيب, the mizan, the scale, that mizan, it's bigger than the seven heavens and the seven earth and what is in between. فالحمدلله, it will fill the mizan. وسبحان الله والحمدلله تملأ أو لتملأان ما بين السماء والأرض. فضائل الأعمال هذه كلها, فضائل أجل الأعمال. When you say سبحان الله والحمدلله, it will fill the what is between the heaven and the earth. Fa he said, Alhamdulillah, it will fill, the mizan will be full of hasanat. Subhanallah, half of the mizan. Wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, it will, subhanallah, the heaven and the earth and what is in between, it will be full too. Subhanallah. According to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there are too many hadiths for this zikr. For example, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, authentic hadith, if you say after the salah, like what you just finished, subhanallah 33 times, alhamdulillah 33 times, Allahu Akbar 33 times, and you say la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, lahul mulk wa lahul hamdu wa ala kulli shayin qadir, huttat khatayak wa law kanat mithla zabad al-bahr. your sin will be wiped out, even if this your sin is big as like the foam of the ocean. Yeah, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe it out. Already we're making this ibadat every day. And they said another hadith, if you say subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanallah al-azim, every day 100 times, what's gonna happen? Allah will forgive your sins, even if it is like the foam of the ocean. See, there are too many fada'il, there are too many rahamat from Allah, too many doors, too many ways from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He can forgive your sin. But you have to know the keys. You have to know what to do it, how to do it. Subhanallah. Yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives a tawfiq to somebody to say this azkar. If somebody make it, means he's guarding his salawat, he's doing his salawat. Subhanallah. Subhanallah, alhamdulillah, tamla'u tamla'u ma bayna as-samawati wal-ard, was-salatu nur. He said in the hadith also, as-salah, it's nur. As-salah, it's that nur. Subhanallah, in your face, in your heart, in your grave, above as-salat, in the day of judgment. That nur, you need it. As-salah, هي ذكر الله الأكبر ولا ذكر الله أكبر أكرن كده آية من الصلاة وإن الله سي ذكر الله sometimes in the آيات said يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله what does ذكر الله means الصلاة yeah don't be occupied with your money your wealth your dunya and you forget your صلاة no الصلاة من حافظ عليها كانت له نورا ونجاة وبرهانا يوم القيامة if you guard your صلاة it will be نور for you It will be a burhan. Burhan means like, يعني visible, يعني دليل, proof with you that Allah سبحانه وتعالى telling Allah, يا رب, I make my salah. ونجاه, you will be saved from the punishment of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the day of judgment if you guard your salawat. And one of the superiority of the salah in the day of judgment You will be known to Rasulullah and to the Ummah of Rasulullah. You are one of the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? قال أمتي يأتون يوم القيامة غرلا محجلين يوم القيامة. غرلا محجلين من أثار الوضوء. سبحان الله. In the day of judgment, your body, your limbs, where you used to make wudu, that will be full of light, shining in the day of judgment. And more light, more you make salah. بقدر ما تحمل من الصلوات بقدر ما يكون معك من النور يوم القيامة. More prayers you are doing, more light will be shining your face, your limbs, your hands, your feet. All of these, subhanAllah, nur. And Rasulullah will recognize you in the day of judgment. He is one of my ummah. Why? Because of your salah. فالصلاه it's نور. الصلاه it's رأس الأمر. It's الأمانة. It's الأمانة. عرضنا الأمانة. على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحمل لها It is the main thing in the أمانة الصلاة connection between you and Allah سبحانه وتعالى فسبحان الله this message is not for you الحمد لله you are coming to صلاة الفجر all the year this message for those who are still staying home those who are still sleeping those who are still سبحان الله working and the very يعني good friends with the شيطان Mr. Khanzab أو أبو مرة That man when he came late to Salat al-Fajr, late, he is praying and he came late for Salat al-Fajr. Rasulullah he said, did Abu Murra urinate in your ears, man? What Abu Murra? Shaitan. Rasulullah did Abu Murra, Shaitan, urinate in your ears? Why you came late for the Salah? What about those who are not praying? Those who are snoring, amwatun ghayru ahya, wa ma yash'uruna ayana yub'athun. They are dead, they are not alive. Ya jama'a, as-salah, very important. There is no any excuse for anybody who's not praying. There is no any excuse. He's in surgery. He's sick. He's handicapped. If his brain is still functioning, working, wallahi al-azim, Allah will ask him about his salawat. Since he was 10 until he died. He will be responsible for his salawat. This message for our families, our kids, our children is Salah, Ra'as al-Amr, the head of everything in Islam. Is Salah. It's the first pillar in Islam practically is Salah. Because saying La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah just with your tongue. Second one is Salah when you practice it as a practice, movement, haraka, work. Is Salah, it is the first pillar in Islam. Yeah, Allah will not accept anything from you without the salah. أول ما يحاسب عليه العبد يوم الخيام. First thing, we will be accountable for it. In the day of judgment, is salah. First station, you will be stopped for the accountability, is salah. If it is okay, alhamdulillah, you're okay. If it is not okay, you are in big trouble with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is salah. And they said in the hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَالصَّدَقَةُ بُرْهَانُ. When you give sadaqah, sadaqah here means zakah also. Sadaqah is zakah. It's a burhan, burhan sata, it's nur for you, proof for you that you are really a mu'min. When you give your money and you, subhanallah, out of your, with good intention that you're giving it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not following your desires. My desire is telling me, this is my money, you're going to give it to me. I don't want to give it to anybody. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you, give zakah and give sadaqah. And they say, no, I'm going to listen to the Allah, not to my nafs. My nafs, my desire, my hawa, just keep this money for your kids or keep it for yourself. Be a rich man. I said, no, I will give it. Actually, it's not sadaqah burhan. يعني subhanallah, zakah, sadaqah, nafaqat, any kind of nafaqah, charity, you giving it, including zakah, that's good for you. Wallahi, Allah will save you from the hellfire, from your problems in this dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يؤجل لك المنايا. Even your death can be deleted because of your sadaqah. Your death, it's written for you, you're going to die certain day. Because of your zakah, because of your sadaqat, Allah said, no, give him more life. Wallahi, give him more because of your sadaqah and your zakah. وَيُنْسَأْ لَهُ فِي أَثَرِهِ Subhanallah, people will remember you with something good. Those who are building masajid or giving Quran or doing digging wells of water for people, whatever, any kind of sadaqat you are doing it fi sabilillah, sponsoring a team, orphan, all of kind of sadaqat. This is subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you a lot. Was sadaqah was zakah come from tazkiyah. Tazkiyah nama, something wrong. Yeah, like what Allah said in the Quran, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِ الصَّدَقَةِ وفي القراءة ويربي الصدقة. أيوة سبحان الله. The riba, Allah will take it away from its roots. No foundation for the riba. No roots for the riba. Usury. But it's the صدقات والنفقات والزكاة والcharity. Allah will grow up for you. قال الصدقة يوم القيامة. سبحان الله. الله عز وجل يربيها لك كما يربي أحدكم فلوة. If you have a little horse and you're taking care of that horse, ما شاء الله. And exercising, training, teaching that Arabian horses became in the end with millions of dollars. Yeah, the Arabian horses, if you train it and you raise it good, oof, millions. I have a lot of friends. يعني they do that. Millions of dollars. You sell the sperm like this with a lot. Subhanallah. Millions. There is no value for this horse. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise that piece of bread, piece of food. Whatever charity you give it, you're going to see it like a mountain of, in the day of judgment of hasanat. Ya Rabbi, this is your sadaqah. I grow it for you. Subhanallah. For that's why very important. Sadaqah, Burhan. والصبر ضياء والقرآن حجة لك وعليك. These days, the days of Quran, يا جماعة. Read the Quran as much as you can. Quran will be حجة for you, inshallah. Quran will take you from your hand to the Jannah, inshallah. The Quran will intercede for you. The Siyam will intercede for you. And these days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was 23rd of, or 24th of Ramadan. When Jibreel came and he was carrying the whole Quran from the book of decree and he gave it to the house of dignity in our heaven here. In Laylat al-Qadr, the whole entire Quran, one time, one shot like this. And after that, in 23 years, he used to give it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, little by little. Surah by surah or verses by verses. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylat al-Qadr. القرآن الكريم سبحان الله القرآن الكريم يا جماعة read it القرآن it will be enough for you والله العظيم in your grave and in the hereafter it will take you to Jannah. Yes, والقرآن حجة لك وعليك كل الناس يغدو. And every morning like this time everybody is going in his own way. فبائع نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها. If you go in the way of الرحمن, Allah, like what you did, you just started your day with salah and ibadat. Now you are freeing your nafs and yourself from the hellfire. يعتقها, you're free. عتق, subhanallah. أو موبقها, and somebody else, he started his day with haram. فحرام plus haram, above haram, subhanallah, equal millions of haram. That person, he is destroying his nafs. موبقها يعني مهلكها. He is in big destruction. So that's why choose your way with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. مسكين الله سبحانه وتعالى يا رب العالمين أن يبارك لنا وإياكم في الشهر الكريم وفي القرآن العظيم، وأن يسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل منا وإياكم صالح الأعمال، وأن يغفر ذنوبنا ويكفر عنا سيئاتنا ويحط عنا خطايانا. اللهم إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا ظلما كثيرا يا رب العالمين، وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. ربنا اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما، وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا يا ربنا شقين ولا محروما. واغفر لنا وتب علينا، واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن كان له حق علينا. اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك يا رب سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا.